Welcome to our channel. This video is dedicated to Metaforsa 2 set. We will demonstrate its step-by-step installation and setup. Base Metaforsa 2 unit for mounting on a DIN rail, 3 motion sensors, 2 leakage sensors, 4 window or door position sensors, 4 temperature sensors, a power supply unit, and a short instruction, which contains QR codes for connecting to the device. Metaforsa 2 module has the following: 10 relay outputs for connecting load, such as lamps, blinds, valves to control heating and water supply, garage gates, locks and fan coils, 4 dimmable channels for connecting dimmable lights, 24 inputs for connecting buttons, switches, read switches, motion sensors and leakage sensors, a port to connect temperature sensors with the possibility of connecting up to 8 sensors, CAN bus for connecting extra devices and sensors, and Ethernet port for connecting to the internet. Install the power supply unit and the Metaforsa 2 module in the electrical service panel. Connect the power supply, internet, buttons, sensors, and load. See the detailed instructions about how to connect various devices to the Metaforsa module by following the link in the upper right corner or in the description of this video. We recommend installing 2 circuit breakers, one for load and the other one for the Metaforsa 2 power supply. If you have extra modules to extend the system, install and connect them, having connected them with CAN bus. Place the terminators at the ends of the CAN bus. Important: elements such as blinds can be damaged if voltage is supplied to the opening and closing channels at the same time. Supplying power to the load before configuring the output channels is not recommended. Supply the power to the Metaforsa unit without supplying it to the load. Make sure that the indication on the module has been turned on, as well as the Ethernet slot LED lights. Install the LarniTech app on your smartphone or tablet. For this, use the QR code which you can find in the Metaforsa set instruction manual. After installing and starting the app, in order to connect to your device, enter the connections menu and scan the QR code from the instruction. Now you can do the setting up of inputs and outputs. Enter the additional menu and activate the edit mode by pressing the edit mode icon. Now enter the additional menu again and hit the setup icon. Here in the modules tab, you can view and configure the inputs and outputs of the modules connected to the system. Click the settings icon of the Metaforsa module and choose the outputs config in the menu that opens. In the dialog window, choose the type of load connected to the module and its parameters. For example, you can choose the blinds and set the time of their opening or a valve to control heating, choosing its type, normally closed or normally open. Save the changes, after which supply the power to the load and check its work. The inputs are configured in the same way, after which the correctness of their work is checked. If there are extension modules, configure and check their work. Then you can create different areas and distribute the devices among them. For this, make sure you are in the edit mode. After this, click the menu of choosing the area and create the rooms you need. Then, with a long press of an icon, you can change its position or move it to another room by dragging it on the menu of choosing the room and then choosing the room you need. Creating rooms and moving elements between them can also be done by going to Setup and then to the Structure tab. A long press of the icon brings the menu from which it is possible to enter the settings of the current element. In the General section, you can change the name of the element, add a voice command, change an icon, or add this element to Favorites. Auto section lets you activate the automation in a few clicks and set up its parameters. In the Schedule section, you can set up the schedule of turning on and off of a certain element, including adjusting it to the time of the sunrise and sunset. For example, Outdoor lights can be turned on an hour after sunset and turned off at 11 p.m. Switches section lets you bind buttons to control a certain executor. For this, first press the button you need. The system will display it, after which you need to press bind and save the changes. Now this button controls the chosen executor. Switches section has extra button settings. You can choose to control them with a double or triple click of a button, as well as choose an action. For example, only to turn on or to turn off the executor. For example, the main lighting can be controlled with one click of a button. Then an individual light can be bound to the same button with a double click. A triple click will activate backlight. This way, one button's single push will control the main lighting, a double tap controls a standalone lamp, and a triple click controls LED lights. In the same way, you can connect the climate and temperature sensors, water valves, and leakage sensors. For this, enter the settings of the heating valve and then the sensor section, where you choose one or multiple temperature sensors, which are within the relevant heating zone. In the automatization section, set up the weekly temperature schedule. After saving the changes, the climatic zone will be maintaining the temperature according to the preset schedule. Then you can create light scenes. For this, choose the corresponding point in the additional menu. In the General tab, enter the name of the scene. In the State tab, add the necessary lights with the help of a long press and set their state. If necessary, you can bind buttons in the Switches tab. Then save the scene. Now, when it is activated, the chosen lights will go into the state you have set. This way you can create several light scenes for various situations. For example, for reading a book or for watching a film. The next stage is setting up automation. Let's say that you need to turn off the light in the hallway when no motion has been detected for 10 minutes. For this, in the Element settings, go to the Automation tab. The Auto Period option sets the time during which automation remains inactive after the manual control of the executor. For example, after turning on this lamp with the help of the app or a button, automation will be turned off for 10 minutes. This parameter is set according to the function of the area. In our case, let's set it to 5 minutes. Then activate automation number 4. Turning off is based on the motion sensor data. Go to automation settings, choose the motion sensor, the threshold of the sensor operation, and the time, 10 minutes. Save the changes. The executor will display an extra icon A, which means that this element has been automated. Now the light will be turned off when the sensor does not detect motion for 10 minutes. For integration with voice assistants, activate the function of voice control in the settings of the elements you need. You will also need to connect your smart home system to voice assistants. You can see how to do it in the instructions, which can be found in the additional menu. After adding new devices, Siri and Google Assistant will refresh the list of devices on their own, while Alexa needs to be told, "Discover new devices." In order to connect cameras, scenarios, or plugins, to set up climate control or update the system, you can use the LT Setup panel. For more details, follow the link in the upper right corner or in the description of this video. LT Setup can also be accessed from the Dealer Administration panel. Setting up or changing the configuration of the system can be done remotely without being present at the site. Every day, a full reserve copy of all settings and of the system configuration is made. It is synchronized with the cloud, making it possible for the system to be restored with a few clicks. The device does not need extra settings to gain cloud access. The app notices the absence of the system in your local network and automatically performs the connection via the cloud. If difficulties arise at any of the stages, you could use the documentation on wiki.larnitech.com or get in touch with the technical support service. Our support service specialists have the ability to connect to the device remotely, check the configuration parameters of the system, and assist you in solving any issues. Thank you for watching this tutorial. See you in the next episode.